gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads we have to walk are winding, and all the lights that lead us there are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Because maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall.
The last time we hired out a camper van and tried camper vanning, we parked it in a car park and stayed in a hotel.
I thought it was going to be a really romantic thing to do for your birthday.
I think the idea was romantic.
But normally, October, I just figured September's warm. October won't be that cold, and it was freezing.
Yeah, it was brutal, wasn't it?
But how cute was the van?
Well, you didn't like the van,
but I loved the van.
Yeah, this is a total upgrade.
I don't think so.
Come on.
The inside of the other one was like all wooden and cute, and it had like plates hanging up and stuff. It was a girl's van. It was a girl's van. This one is designed beautifully.
I honestly way prefer the look of the old VW camper vans. But the thing is, if you get one of those, it's just going to break down every 10 seconds.
Well, you know, when you said to me, let's rent one, that's what I had in my mind. I had like a powder blue VW with the white bit on the top, and like all these shots in my head of like Instagrams that we could get, and then the white van pulled up outside. Yeah, the old one's much nicer.
I feel like I could really get into camper vanning now.
Yeah, me too.
1 hour and 40 minutes will be there, guys.
Time for some context. Around 25 years ago, someone decided to make a new forest. It would be England's first man-made forest in over 1,000 years. 8.5 million trees were planted over 200 square miles by local communities and landowners and Jobsworths. And the Timber Forest Festival, that happens right here in said forest. We were invited here by our new partners, LL Bean, these guys. They're a family-owned business that started in the United States in 1912 by this dude, Leonwood Bean.
Sell good merchandise at a reasonable profit, treat customers like human beings, and they'll always come back for more.
That was Leon Woodbean's golden rule, and it worked. They're huge in America, and now they're coming across the pond and setting up over here in the UK. They asked us to let you guys know about them and what they're all about. In exchange, they're inviting us to a load of awesome festivals over the summer. So a massive thank you to them for working with us and giving us all these amazing things to point our cameras at.
I've just set up the camper van. It's wicked. Let me show you around this thing. I've spun the two front seats around, so they're like, I'm set up the little table. Got the little back seat set up. This is what folds down for like Hannah and my bed. It's got like an upstairs bedroom. So this here is the upstairs bed. This is where Grayson here is going to sleep with Rufus. There's a safety net here behind me, which goes all around the back to stop Rufus being able to get out.
Yay! Oh, I want to sleep up here. I'm jealous.
I want to sleep up here too.
This is so cool.
That's our fridge. That's our stove and our sink. This is it, man. I love it. I'm going to do this first time because I've done it 3 or 4 times now, so it should be easy.
Do you remember we stayed in this? Yes, you do, you bum. I'm not a climbing frame, mister. I'm a human being with emotions and dreams and feelings. You can't call me a climbing frame.
Yes, I can.
Why?
Oh,
is that right, is it? You think that's okay, do you? I made you, so remember that. You've got to give me some respect. Oh my God, I am literally MacGyver. I don't think anyone's going to know who MacGyver is. There is under 38. Let me explain who MacGyver is.
For those of you that are unfamiliar with the cult classic 80s TV series called simply MacGyver, please allow me to expand your tiny mind. MacGyver is a resourceful and ingenious troubleshooting secret agent who improvises his way out of sticky situations using everyday items. His iconic haircut is what they call a mullet, in a clean-cut, slightly gelled variation on the classic hairstyle. The term MacGyver has now become part of the colloquial American English lexicon. When one MacGyvers a solution to a problem, one finds a simple yet elegant solution to something using existing resources. I, like every other man in the world, wishes they could be a bit more like MacGyver. Sadly, I'm just a twat.
There is absolutely zero joy to be had in putting up a tent.
When I bought this, I said to the guy, you need to give me the easiest tent to erect. So he gave me this one. And it still takes me consistently about 40 minutes to put it up because I'm such a bloody idiot. But I've done it. It's done. It's erected. Any Swedish people watching, you'll be seeing this in the future, so deepest condolences for your miserable attempt at beating us. It's coming home. Mark my
the
words.
Ball's coming
it's coming
it's
home.
Coming home.
Chav. Can you say chav these days?
Grayson's made himself a makeshift bed in the booth.
Right, we're going to go and check out the festival.
Yay! And we have a sleeping baby. Woo!
Saying this is your first festival.
Very first ever festival.
That's weird considering like you're around in the 60s.
Yeah. Well no, I was born in 57, so I was 3 in the 60s.
Well, you know, you were still around in the 60s. I had a glitter beard the last time I went to the festival.
Oh, I wonder if they would do that this time.
I definitely want another glitter beard because it was the best thing that ever happened to me.
I really want you to. I really enjoyed that.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
There was something magical that I found really attractive about that, which really confused me.
Later, isn't it? I would actually contest that. How on earth did Andrew's friend...
It's 28 degrees outside and it's lovely, but it's a little bit too hot for me and the kids. So we're just chilling here. Gracie's got an ice cream, Grandma's got a seat, and Ruben is like so chilled. He's got so many things to look at. So.
She heard his big voice booming in her head. You may change to any shape you wish. Just imagine it, my child. And she closed her eyes. And when the slave trader came back, ready to set sail, rather than Mestra, he saw a grizzled old fisherman. He sold the sheep, the next day he sold you.
We won the football!
Sorry, Swedish people, but you're terrible at football. And we're totally going to win the World Cup.
You'll all know by the time you're watching this that we were kicked out of the World Cup by Croatia on a 2-1 defeat. A goal secured in extra time by Mario Mandzukic shattered the hearts of an already divided nation. And this incredibly handsome yet smug face was about to be reduced into something that looked more like this.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk.
But you know what? As the journalist Jonathan Liu put it, in the end, it didn't matter that football didn't come home. What mattered was that scintillating month-long feeling that it just might. Besides, we all know us English are bad losers, but there is one thing we're far worse at. Winning.
When you are alone, do you think about him? Waiting by the phone to see if he's calling out. Has he called you now? I've been by your side for 10 years and counting, dealing with your lies inside.
Are you guys having fun up here?
Yeah.
Are you having fun up here, Roof Roof?
How about this? How about this tonight? I'm sleeping in the classroom, but not with Roo.
Yeah, you want to sleep with Grandma in the tent?
That's why I'm just making Roo happy. And when I want to come out, I won't come out because then I'll make him sad and then I don't want to make him sad.
Oh, high five to that, dude. Yeah, you're such a good big brother.
Rufus is not settling very well upstairs in the upstairs part of the camper van.
And Grayson has just stopped him from freaking out.
I'm being a bear, just a brown bear.
Oh, a grizzly bear.
No, a handsome bear.
You're a handsome bear.
The darkness now. Remember all of the lies that you say. Remember,
he's happy now.
Rufus.
That was a long 3 hours.
Rufus, 3 hours of crying is not cool.
That's the most he's ever cried in his whole life. He does not like camping.
He doesn't like camping, does he?
Oh no, he doesn't like going to sleep without everybody else. That's the problem.
Remember all of the lies you say.
Did you get any sleep?
Yeah.
I think we had about 4 hours sleep all together.
Oh, wow.
What about you?
Yeah, about the same.
Morning, Grayson.
Morning, Rufus.
Morning, Grayson. Morning, Grayson.
Morning, Rufus.
No.
I just wanna let you know that I have a crush on you. I can't wait forever, girl, to say how I feel.
Caravan life.
Woo!
They're just like scrabbling around here together.
Steph and I have been getting a couple of pictures for Instagram and my blog. We did miss golden hour last night.
Grayson, what have you just pressed? Don't touch any of that stuff. I keep telling you, do not touch anything on the dashboard. I've told you 15 times, stop it now. Sorry for interrupting.
We did miss golden hour last night because Rufus just did not want to go to sleep. So tonight, I think we're going to scrap bedtime altogether, be completely chilled out parents, and take them both into the festival and hope that one of them falls asleep in the buggy. And if not, we're just going to roll with it, says the most uptight, neurotic mum ever.
Grayson, go in there and press that red button. No, you can do it. Go on, just press it.
What's he doing?
He's pressing that red button.
Oh, Stefan, don't do that. That's mean.
You'll get wet if you press it.
That's so mean. Do you know how many dramas that would have caused?
We thought we'd quickly just take a second to talk about the reasons why we didn't upload a video last Sunday.
Should we shut the door? Is that...
Yeah, shut the door.
...going to annoy you?
Yeah, just so we don't... Just so it's nice having
okay,
audio.
That's better.
Yeah. So we thought we'd talk about it because... Hang on, is that too dark now? Are we too dark?
I don't think so. You can lighten it up anyway.
I'll crank that up a little bit here.
Oh, I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah, you can. There we go.
I guess it's, in a way, it's quite a personal subject to talk about.
Like, yeah.
We don't ever, ever talk about our relationship on YouTube. It's a very sacred, private thing to us, so...
It's funny to say we film it.
Yeah, but we don't talk about it.
But I feel like sometimes I think we both feel slightly... disingenuous when we are constantly streaming out these slow motion montages of us skipping down a beach, holding hands or embracing each other on some Greek island, and people, you know, may have a tendency to watch that and think, oh, that's kind of an accurate reflection of what a relationship should be.
We do have a very good relationship.
We've been best
friends the whole time we've known each other. Our relationship is great, but it doesn't come without arguments and pits and...
Yeah.
There's obviously, we don't...
We fall off the wagon sometimes.
Yeah, and obviously we don't film those or talk about that.
Well, Grayson's had a meltdown. Well, a spider's probably crawled over his foot.
You okay, Gracie?
We do sometimes go through very rocky patches.
And the thing is that that's normal.
Yeah, of course,
but
yeah.
Obviously we don't film or talk about that, so it looks like completely 100% perfect. Like, I could still sometimes feel like we're in this weird dream and it can't really be real and stuff, but in reality it's like it's not always like that.
Yeah,
and it shouldn't be like that. It would be weird if we never argued.
No,
I personally like watching people on YouTube where I feel like I can escape into their lives for a little bit. I forget what's going on with mine. I forget what deadlines I've got. I forget what time the kids are going to wake up. Anything that I'm worried about or stressed about disappears because I go into somebody else's life. And I think that's sometimes why we choose to represent things the way we do, is because I know lots of people that follow us probably do the same thing as me. So you don't want to be like, oh, we had a raging argument last night, so we don't really feel like filming this week.
Yeah, and I think if we were to try and film that week, and if we were to try and like brush it under the carpet, what we would be producing would be an act. And what we're trying to do with these videos, which a lot of you guys will already see, is we're trying to kind of set cameras up in a way that we forget about them and just chat normally, and you capture this stuff, which is the real version of us, more real than what we're doing now, which is essentially presenting.
And the thing is that if you film after you've had an argument, you are acting, and we're not actors.
Especially
me. You can act, I can't. I'm annoyed or sad or upset, I'm just like, I'm a write-off.
Yeah.
I'm a complete write-off.
Yeah, so last week we kind of fell off the wagon. It took a few days to recover from it. It's all good, like it's fine. Marriages hit these like points where you're just like, where it's difficult and it's hard and you have to work for them.
Our relationship's always been very passionate, so when we get on, it's amazing and we're like best mates and we just want to spend all our time together, and when we don't get on, it's horrific.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
So yeah.
Anyway, so that's it. That's why. The important thing is about these videos, you need to go into it with a healthy mind
and
at the start of the week, where you're raring to go and you're just feeling in a good place mentally, physically, and you're there. And if you're not quite there, it'll transcend into the work that we output and it won't be good. Right, so we're going to go get our face painted now in the festival. Because
let's get your beard glittered.
Yeah, let's get my beard glittered.
You look slightly deflated by that.
I'll lose
prospect.
My deposit on this place if it's covered in glitter.
You know, sometimes you see like a dad in combat trousers with loads of wrinkles that just does whatever their wife says. I just saw a glimmer of that.
God.
You were like, right. Yeah, let's get my beard glittered.
You look so excited about it. I didn't want to let you down by being like,
but
I can't really be bothered.
Everyone loves the gold beard, and it made a really nice Instagram shot.
I did enjoy the gold beard. The gold beard was
see,
fabulous.
See, guys, behind the Instagram, doesn't want the beard glittered. Mm. It's really impractical. It's itchy.
It gets everywhere.
But it's a really nice shot.
Yeah, I'll do it. Right, we're going to go check out the festival now.
Let's get you lying in
that's
the
why we didn't upload. Shush. That's why we didn't upload last week. I feel much better now we've spoke about that.
We're heading back into the festival. It's taken us pretty much all morning to just organise ourselves. Not very organised people. And then I see some people's camper vans with everything really neatly folded up and put away, and I'm like, why are we not like that? Grayson, what have you found?
A treasure.
I would have just jumped on and tried to have a go,
They've got these balance ropes set up between these trees, and I've always seen people doing them in parks and stuff, and I always thought I would be so good at that, because if there's one thing I'm good at, it's balance. So I'm going to give it a go, see if I really am that good. Bear in mind, I've never done this before.
Let go of the tree.
Why is my leg wobbling? Wobbling.
Crop out the stick cones.
No way!
Crop out the
bastard.
Stick.
Bastard.
Crop out the stick. Or I'll do it in post production.
I know you will. This is exactly what our chat was about earlier. You little bastard.
They just put up a sign saying they've run out of ice cream.
Yeah, they did.
They ran out, and then we're left. Don't worry, I can eat some broccoli. Eat some broccoli instead.
Nah.
Yeah, come on, we'll get some broccoli. Come on.
He's had a mint ice cream.
A mint one?
Yeah. Glitter time. Chipped in the way that you held me. I thought it would be easier to stay. I thought it would be
easy. Do you remember when you found me? It was about this point in the process of my glitter beard application that I thought to myself, Steph, you want to be more like MacGyver, yet here you are perched on a lilac cushion while a mermaid princess gently applies glitter to your beard. What are you doing, mate? This isn't the right path to unearthing your inner MacGyver, Steph. In fact, this is the exact opposite path. But then I realised something. Maybe this is a MacGyver move. Think about it. You're a couple of bad guys selling enriched plutonium at a woodland festival to any festival-loving rogue dictators. You're going to want to be pretty discreet about it, we can all agree on that. And what, dear viewer, is a better disguise than a duo of glittery face painters? This isn't an 80s TV series, but if it was, I would have just saved the world and got a fabulous glittery sparkly beard at the same time. Let's consider that MacGyver 2.0.
Do you like it?
I'm very much enjoying the blue beard.
Isn't it sensational? Isn't it fabulous? Gross? What do you mean gross?
It's coming to the end of our time at the festival. I think it finishes tonight. But it's been amazing. It's been such good fun.
The plan was to stay in the camper van for two nights, but we decided last minute to leave a bit early. The main reason is because we forgot to pack an essential item, towels. And if there was one thing we all needed, it was a long hot shower. And let's face it, nobody wants to see a family of overly entitled vloggers drip dry. Take off your signs, a swan that I call bird. I'd like to say another massive thank you to our partners LL Bean for inviting us to the Timber Festival this year. We're really excited to be working with them over the next few weeks on some festival themed shenanigans. We'll put a link to all the LL Bean clothes we wore in the festival on our want feeds. Thanks for watching, everyone, and we'll see you all next week.